In this video, we're going to take a look at IronCAD catalogs. Catalogs are a key component within IronCAD and are used throughout the entire design process. They're very, very powerful, but also very easy to use. To begin, let's take a look at the standard catalogs that come with IronCAD. The first catalog is the Shapes catalog, and this contains a lot of basic building components that you use throughout the design process. The next catalog is the Advanced Shapes catalog, which contains more advanced shapes for creating designs. We have the Sheetmetal catalog, which contains the components that you would use to create sheet metal parts. The Tools catalog, which contains advanced tools, such as doing automated assembly explosion, creating fasteners, creating bearings, things like that. Next, we have the Animation catalog, which allows you to drag and drop in animations into your design. We have the Surfaces catalog that contains advanced surface finishes. We have the Textures catalog, which contains texture maps that can be applied to your design. Then we have Bumps, which are bump maps that can be applied. And then we have finally Colors, which have a variety of different colors that can be dragged and dropped onto your design. You can also create as many catalogs as you would like. To create a catalog, all you do is simply go to the Common ribbon bar and then click the New button. And this will create a new catalog. As we do this here, you can see we now have a new catalog 2, at the bottom of the screen. To add a component to a catalog, it's as simple as selecting the component and then, with the left mouse button, dragging it into the catalog. So you'll see here, we're going to take this green piece and just simply drag it right into the catalog. Now that it's in the catalog, in order to use this in another design or within this design again, all I have to do is simply drag it, again with the left mouse button, and into the 3D scene. And that way I'm placing content into my design. So you can see with the catalogs, it's simple as a mouse click for creating new designs. Now, what if your assembly has some linked files inside of it? For example, the blue base here is actually linked to another file on my hard drive. What happens if I drag that into the catalog? Well, catalogs are intelligent enough to realize that this is a linked file. So when you go to drop it in the catalog, it asks you, do you wish to maintain the link to the original file? If I say yes, then any changes I make to the original file will automatically be reflected in the catalog. This ensures the most up-to-date information inside of your catalogs. We also have various catalog sets. To see some other catalog sets, we'll just go to the Common Ribbon tab again, and then click on the Catalog Sets button. And you'll see here we have three default sets. Now you can create as many sets of catalogs as you'd like. You can save your catalogs either to your hard drive or you can save them anywhere on the network. And in this example, we'll just open up our rendering catalog set. And now with that catalog set open, you see we have a wide variety of different types of materials that can be dragged and dropped on to our designs. You can also drag and drop in surface textures into a catalog. If you have a particular surface finish that you'd like to add into a catalog, simply click on the visualization ribbon bar and then select the eyedropper tool. Similar to what you would do inside of a graphics package, we simply move the mouse over the surface finish that we want and press the mouse button to select the color. Then move the mouse into the catalog and press the mouse button again, and we'll automatically place the surface texture into the catalog. And now this surface texture can be dragged and dropped onto a variety of other elements. And that's a brief overview of the IronCAD catalogs.